Hello everyone, my name is Lã Hoàng Quý and welcome to another YouTube video. So in this video, I will talk to you about the introduction to K-means clustering. So now the question is, what is clustering? So clustering So let's explain to it for a bit before we start writing some code. So being able to find groups of similar data that exist in your data set can be extremely valuable. So if you are trying to find underlying meaning, so if you were a store owner and you wanted to understand which customer are more valuable without a set idea of what valuable is, clustering would be a great place to start to find patterns in your data. So you may have a few high level ideas of what denotes a valuable customer, but you are not entirely sure in the face of a large mountain of available data. So through clustering, you can find commonalities among similar groups in your data. So if you look more deeply at a cluster of similar people, you may learn that everyone in that group visits your website for longer periods of time than others. So this can show you what the value is and also provide a clean sample size for future supervised learning experiment. So now let's talk about the K-means. So one of the most basic yet popular approaches is by using a cluster analysis called K-means. Clustering. So K means work by searching for K cluster in your data, and the workflow is actually quite intuitive. So we will start with the Nomad introduction to K-means and followed by an implementation in Python. So we use the Colab notebook in here, and the Nomad algorithm of K-means clustering is shown here. So first we need to pick K centroids, which is K equal to the expected distinct number of clusters. The second one is randomly place K centroid anywhere amongst your existing training data. And then the third one is calculate the Euclidean distance from each centroid to all the points in your training data. And then the next one is training data points get group with get group in with their nearest centroid. The next one is amongst data points group into each centroid calculate the mean data point and move your centroid to that location. And the last one is repeat this process until conversion or when the membership in each group no longer changes. So now we will start to implement the case mean. So we just implement the symbol k means from scratch. So implementing k means from scratch. So we need to from sklearn.dataset import make underscore blobs, and then from and then we need to import matplotlib.pyplot as plt, and then we need to import numpy as np, and then we need to import mat. So let's run the cell. So from should be from sklearn. So the next step is we need to generate a random cluster data set to experiment on x equal to coordinate points and y equal cluster labels, and define random centroid. So we need to get x comma y equal make underscore blobs, and then we got number of samples, so you can change, you can choose any sample you want. So I just choose 1500. In here is center equal 3, and then you got is the number of features is equal to 2, and you got random size is equal to 800. So now we need to define the centroid. So I just make the centroids equal to the array with the negative 6 comma 2 comma 3 comma negative 4 comma negative 5 comma 10. So this one should be outside here. So let's run the cell, and now let's bring x to see what is happening. So this is your x, and we need to plot the coordinate points. So we have is plt dot scatter. It will be x comma 0 comma x semicolon comma 1 comma s equal 50 comma c map equal to top 20b. So plt dot show. So this is the cluster. As you can see, it's split to different cluster. So if we bring y, well, it should be small y. So that's why I have the error. So this is an array of the y. So if we copy this plot, So we got is, we need to add one more thing, which is C equal to Y. And then let's run the cell. And we got this plot like this. And that is all in this video. So I hope you enjoy it. And if you like this video, please press like and subscribe to this channel. And I really do appreciate it. And that is all in this video. And I will see you in the next video.